All right, so we're going to do some episode comparisons here. Right now, this menu is from the official release of the Extreme Ghostbusters. Now, before I play this episode, better make sure you have your 3D glasses. Oh, and by the way, make sure they're charged. Because that's the only way you're going to see this episode and probably the rest of the 15 others. Just wonderful. Look at the quality of this. Just wonderful. Look how blurry that is. It looks like there's like a double image on there.
Hey, tell the boss we finally busted through.
What was down here, but something tells me we shouldn't be disturbing it. Maybe we ought to seal it back up.
Oh yeah? And tell the boss what?
Okay, now we're gonna compare the bootleg episode to this one. Okay, and now we have the Extreme Ghostbusters Disc 1, the bootleg version. Let's go to the episodes. Let's play it. What a difference. I could definitely see this a lot much more clearer. It's not jumping.
Hey, tell the boss we finally busted through.
I don't know what was down here, but something tells me we shouldn't be disturbing it. Maybe we ought to seal it back up.
Oh, yeah? And tell the boss what? The man wants to do something running through here before the next election.
Well, that's it for the bootleg one. Now let's check out the official UK release of the Extreme Ghostbusters Volume 1. Okay, so here we have the official UK version release of the Extreme Ghostbusters. And you see it says play all episodes, audio subtitles, episode selection. Let's go to Darkness at Noon Part 1. Such as airlines, clubs, hospitals, hotels, oil rigs. Way better.
Hey, tell the boss we finally busted through.
Now this is watchable, along with the bootlegs.
I don't know what was down here, but something tells me we shouldn't be disturbing it. Maybe we ought to seal it back up.
Oh yeah? And tell the boss what? The man wants to do something running through here before the next election.
Well, there you have it. That is the episode comparison of the Extreme Ghostbusters from the official release to the bootleg release to the UK official release. We'll check out some of the other episodes from the official release. It painfully hurts. Alright, so again, this is Disc 1 of the official release of the Extreme Ghostbusters. Let's check out Darkness at Noon Part 2.
Last time on Extreme Ghostbusters.
Damn, you got Spangler.
You believe in ghosts?
He's got scientific proof that they exist.
They do.
What are you talking about? Is he
a ghost?
Paranormal Phenomena 101.
So, yeah, you can see the quality is horrible. There is about, you have to probably get to disc 4 or about disc 5 for it to really look a lot better. Some people might say, yeah, I guess I'll keep the set And I, you know, I guess I could agree with that part if you're okay with having 15 to 20 episodes looking like you need to wear 3D glasses and it is really bad. You don't believe me, just hop on Amazon, look at the reviews, check it out for yourself. Again, this is just, Sony needs to reach out to all of us and send us replacements. There's no way in hell this should be happening. They shouldn't give us bad transfers. I mean, hopefully, from the masters, hopefully they're not damaged. Because you just saw that I compared the official release to the bootleg release. And then I also compared it to another release, which is the UK official release of Volume 1 that has a complete 13 episodes, and you could really see the differences. So, having about 15 episodes, some people might say, yeah, I'll keep the set. But there's a lot of people that replied to me so far. And even some of my friends, like, we're really big Ghostbusters fans. And he had nothing but negative things to say about it. Like, it was just blurry. It looked like doubled images on top of each other. Weird artifacts you can see. It just does not look good. I was reading that several people said they tried it on CRT TVs to see if it looks better. Which is, of course, for those who don't know, is the old school big bag TVs that are made of glass. Some people tried it on smaller LCD screens. They tried it pretty much on, I guess, whatever devices that they could put it on. And people said it really looks bad, and yeah, it does. And I am not satisfied with this set. Sony needs to reach out to us, redo this, and send us replacements. They should send everybody replacements for free, honestly. And if it's not gonna be for free, then honestly, make it like 10 bucks and just call it a night. That's all I have to say about this. I mean, I showed you guys the differences between the official bootleg and UK release.